Sarah Champion backstage at Rewind Henley, and joining our happy camper van now is none other than Kevin from Fiction Factory. How are you?
Hi, I'm not too bad, thanks.
How was the set?
It was, as you can see, very hot and sweaty. We Scots don't take very kindly to the sun, so yes, it was a little bit sweaty.
Well, actually, Hue and Cry played in the pouring rain earlier on, so you actually had the better end of that deal, I think.
Yeah, I think so. It wasn't too bad, actually. It was okay. I was just joking.
How was Rewind Perth playing to the home crowd for you?
It was great. I think it was more surprise and astonishment that five old people could actually get back on stage again and do what they did before.
So tell us the story behind the reunion, because, you know, you read all sorts. I read that you reunited, well, for a friend's wedding, essentially.
We didn't really do anything for a long, long time. And then Eddie, the keyboard player, got married again. And they said, well, wouldn't it be a really good thing if we got together? So it was just myself and Eddie. And then the organisers somehow or other tracked me down to my work. And they said, hey, would you like to come and do Rewind? I said, what's that? And they explained it all and said, yeah, that would be quite good. I'll see if I can get anybody else to do it. And I thought I'd maybe get one or two people, but to my surprise, everybody said they would do it. So much surprise, because Mike, the drummer, actually lives in America. So we couldn't have done it without Facebook.
Right, that's the second time Facebook has been name checked today.
Yeah, well, we couldn't have, because there's no way of contacting him otherwise. So he said yes, and that was it.
And the rest is history. And you look like you're having a lot of fun up there. So is this the start of things to come?
The other guys in the band would like us to do more, but I'm not entirely sure about that. I think I might be getting, given the sweat levels, I think I might be getting a bit old for it.
Never say never. Absolute Radio 80s is an astonishing thing to us now. It's the most popular digital station. It's, you know, figures through the roof. What is it, do you think, about 80s music that's brought the thousands of people here today as well?
I think, not to get too into it, but I think possibly that there's just something, obviously the songs are important, but I think there's just something about the 80s and starting out with electronic music, and I don't know, maybe people think of that, harking back that naivety of trying to figure out how to get a sound and not really have the technology. So I think it's possibly got something to do with that. Everybody was kind of starting out at that point, and I think that's possibly what it is. That's what I think anyway.
If you could go back and give your 80s self one piece of advice, yeah, what would it be?
Don't grow old. That's about it, I think.
Really?
Yeah. Because you get very sweaty, you know, it's just horrible. Not good.
I'm imagining reality TV shows have come knocking over the years, have they?
No, everybody's left us alone.
Really?
I think the reason is because our song Feels Like Heaven is very well known, but the band isn't. And I think I'd always wanted that when I wrote the song. I thought it'd be really great if the song kind of took a life of its own, and everybody kind of goes, Feels Like Heaven, yeah, but, oh, who was it that did that? Oh, I don't know. Because it's always the case that, you know, if I say I was in a band, and they say, oh, what was the band? And they say, I say Fiction Factory. And they always look at me as if I've just insulted them, or they're not quite sure if I'm kidding them on. Fiction Factory. And then you go, Feels Like Heaven. They go, oh, yeah, feels like, yeah. Oh, that's who they were. So, yeah, I'd always wanted the song to live on rather than the band.
Yeah. So you've been left alone, which is probably a good thing.
Yes. Nobody's bothered us until now. Rewind, you've got a lot to answer for.
Yeah, and suddenly all the paps are out in force. What do you make? I mean, there are so many 80s influenced current bands. Do you have any favourites of the current kind of crop?
That's rather embarrassing. I don't really. I mean, I tend not to really listen to too much music nowadays. I do kind of the odd trawl of iTunes to find out what's going on at the moment, but I tend to buy compilations and just do that. So I don't really have, you know, favourites or I think, you know, it's a great band, and possibly because I'm kind of a bit older now, and you tend not to have that. You've got different perspective, different emphasis on your life. You know, I've got family, married and whatever, and I think that's possibly to do with it. But I think like a lot of people here today, they probably have a vast back catalogue of old music, and possibly not too much that's current, I don't know, but that's certainly the way I am.
I don't know, you know, how much you've been out there to just soak up the festival atmosphere, but it's a great atmosphere out there.
Yeah, it is. It's a very kind of chilled atmosphere. Kind of different from other festivals, I believe, because of course, being so old, I don't go to festivals. But I believe that it's a very kind of different atmosphere, both out front and backstage. It's, you know, guys walking around with their kids and, you know, with their wives and the partners and whatever, and it's really, really great. You know, it's really, really interesting.
It's a really nice feel to it, I think. And some of the costumes, I don't know if you had a bird's eye view from the stage, they're quite something.
Yeah, there's one or two luminous outfits there. I'm kind of, yeah, a little bit suspect, but good fun. I did a little bit of research before I came on stage to figure out, you know, what was current at that time, and it was Cabbage Patch Dolls, of course, and I was partial to a bit of luminous wristbands myself. I think we actually set the trend with luminous wristbands.
Do you? Fiction Factory lay claim to that trend?
We were the first luminous wristband wearing act of the 80s, I promise you.
Well, if you can lay claim to nothing else, you've got that.
Absolutely, yeah.
It's been such a pleasure. Are you going to stick around the festival and enjoy some of the acts tonight?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm not quite sure when we're going. We'll go at some point, but got to hang around. It's been almost 30 years since we've done anything, so it would be a shame to just toddle off now.
Yeah, I think you deserve a beer.
Thanks very much. Cheers.
Thanks a lot.